Продовжуємо роботу в Українському кризовому медіа-центрі, і я запрошую до слова полковника Олександра Мотузяника, речника Міністерства оборони України з питань АТО.
Друзі, вітаємо всіх.
Dear friends, I would like to greet everybody, and first of all, I would like to congratulate the journalists of Ukraine with their professional holiday, the Mass Media Workers Day, and also today we celebrate the 25th anniversary from the day when the military TV and radio studio was established after Ukraine gained its independence. And now I come closer to the topic of our today's briefing, in course of which I will cover the latest events along the contact line in the east. In Lugansk sector, the combat activities started after 2 p.m. and lasted till late night. Between Krymske and Novotashkivske along the front line, the occupants four times used mortars and one time they used artillery for opening fire, and thus they launched 50 mines and other shells. The fire was opened from different directions from the enemy's positions. Also, several military provocations were in Stanichna, Lugansky and Popasnyansky districts, but there the situation was a bit more quiet, where the occupants did not use heavy weaponry. In Lugansk sector in general, there were 12 shellings during last 24 hours. In Donetsk sector, the situation became more tense. Near Avdiivka and Donetsk airport, each position of Ukrainian servicemen was under shelling. The combat activities started after noon and lasted till the end of the day. More than 230 mine bombs and around three dozens of tank shells were fired over Ukrainian positions. Also, snipers were used. Also, near Gorlevka, the situation was rather hot. The mortar shellings injured one civil resident in Verkhnya Toretsk. Along the Svitlodarsk bridge, the situation was rather quiet. In general, in Donetsk sector, there were 26 shellings, and out of them, 17 were with the use of heavy weaponry. In Mariupol sector, the entire contact line between Krasnogorivka up to the Azov Sea saw the use of heavy weaponry. In Bogdanivka, 16 missiles were launched from the HAIL missile installations. In Pavlopol, the enemy's mines and shells targeted the local school premises and ruined it considerably. Also, the precinct of patrol service premises were ruined. Besides that, the gas supply pipeline, electric line, and water supply pipeline were damaged. In general, yesterday in Mariupol sector, there were 39 enemy shellings, and one third of them from heavy weaponry. During the last 24 hours, in result of combat activities, there were no death casualties among Ukrainian troops, but four servicemen were wounded. The intelligence department suggests that the enemy's trainers intensified their training in shooting down the drones, and especially they study and are trained to shut down the drones used by a monitoring mission of the OSCE. Quite often, the unmanned aerial vehicles of the OSCE mission registered heavy weaponry, which was prohibited by Minsk agreements, and Russian production weaponry present along the contact line. In the Donetsk region, the court verdict liberated a former member of Band Formation from criminal responsibility since he committed no criminal offenses. This man was part of the Band Formation but back in 2014, but later he understood that there were no positive perspective and voluntarily informed the law enforcement agencies about his past. He also provided the investigation with necessary information. In Mariupol, the National Guards and police men held out military exercises in repealing the subversive agents' attack at a checkpoint. In Odessa, the National Guard servicemen held a contest between grenade launching experts, and the objective of this contest was to raise combat skills of the grenade launchers and also to commemorate the heroic actions of Yevgen Telnov, famous grenade launcher who became a hero near Ilovaisk. Thank you very much.